Hey beloveds, welcome to another episode of Beanie TV, where I offer you sprinkles of spiritual sassiness so you know what to do. Let's get into today's affirmation. Go ahead and close your eyes, take a deep breath in, release. Everywhere I am, there is the possibility of good. Everywhere I am, there is the possibility of good. Everywhere I am, there is the possibility of good. Go ahead and take a deep breath in. Release. Okay, so I'm not outside. I'm actually at work. You gotta do what you can with what you have, honey. Do what you can with what you have. Okay, so something that's been on my heart to talk to you guys about is inner child healing. Sometimes as adults, we self-sabotage, we hurt ourselves, we date the same shitty person over and over again. We don't treat our bodies well. We don't allow ourselves to be sexually confident. We lash out at people we love, and sometimes it's not so much like, you know, I love a good affirmation, but sometimes it's not keep doing these affirmations. Sometimes it's, what do I need to heal? What is within me that I'm not getting a grasp on? What is in me that is still a wound? And I've been doing inner child healing for the past like 8 years. It's one of the first things I learned how to do on this consciousness enlightenment journey. And basically, we all go through things as children. Even if you had the most amazing parents like I did, nobody's perfect. Nobody's parents are perfect. Nobody's parents' parents are perfect. Nobody's great-grandparents are perfect. Like, we all mess up and we all fall short. Nonetheless, when our parents or whoever raises us fall short, we receive that hurt, that trauma, that pain. We receive that energetically. And as adults, the energy is still on us and we just have to heal it. It shows up, it can show up in skin issues, it can show up in heavy periods, whatever it is. So with inner child healing, what we're basically doing is we are visualizing in our mind's eye the first time you felt betrayed, hurt, lost, confused as a child. As children, we are pure spirit, okay? We come straight from God. And then society and life and mistakes of the people that love us just cause us to get bruised and hurt, you know, while on this journey. And, you know, the most important thing is to remember no resentment, right? No resentment, no finger pointing, no blame. Even while you're healing, you're gonna want to finger point and blame and have resentment. Don't keep it there. Let it flow through you. But going back to the inner child healing, so for me, I can think of when I was 2 years old, that is when my father left, and that is a form of trauma. It doesn't matter how many times you hear that story in society, and the way my father left was very not normal. So that is a trauma. Okay, having a parent who loved you so deeply every single day of your life from the day you were conceived, loved you, and then for them to be gone, that is a form of trauma. So what I do is I envision my two-year-old self in my mind's eye, close my eyes, get in a quiet place. I think about myself at two. I let the feelings of sadness, of abandonment, of confusion come up. And me, as the adult that I am, I envision myself holding my two-year-old self, telling her, it's okay, I love you, you are loved, this is not your fault, this is divine order. And in my mind, I imagine this, and every single time, I'm like sobbing, crying. I do it with my two-year-old self, I've done it with my 16-year-old self when I lost my virginity, I've done it with my 18-year-old self who didn't know what she wanted to do and decided to go to school for fashion when that wasn't really her thing. I do it for my 24, 25, 26-year-old self when I was in LA and going through hard times. Like, you have to let your higher self love the previous versions of yourself. This is going to allow you to get out that extra energy. This is going to allow you to heal and really heal so that you can move on and be better for those around you, and forgive. When we don't forgive others, it is us drinking the poison. forgive others, release resentment, release blame, and be your own emotional support, be your own parent, be your own lover, be your own safe space. I can do another video on true inner child meditation another day when I'm not at work in this super random room. But I hope you guys do this weekend. I love you so much. I want you to be healed. I want you to be whole. Be sure to email me at beanietvo@gmail.com if you would like to book a 1-hour soul session with your girl, as well as DM me on BeanieTV to receive my self-love e-course and share this video, thumbs up, and get us to 10,000 subscribers by January 1st, 2020. I love you guys.